Hi, my name's Ian Van Tile, and this is Tangent, a 2005 Beneteau 343. This particular vessel is located here at San Diego, at the San Diego Yacht Club. Come on aboard, let me tell you a little bit about some of the features and benefits that Tangent has to offer. One thing we're going to notice here is we have a really nice wide transom. For a 34-foot vessel, this transom possesses a lot of room to be able to jump off, go swimming. We have a three-step ladder that goes into the water that allows you really good access into the vessel. Just across is the stainless steel magma barbecue. We have an outboard, dinghy outboard bracket that's mounted on the stern rail here, which is really nice. Also, we have the swim step shower. This is a hot and cold swim step shower that's at the transom, and then a 30-amp shore power inlet. One really unique feature about this is the transom seat itself folds down to create a much larger, really nice enclosed cockpit. And then for ease of boarding in and out of the vessel, it flips up on its side, allowing really nice passageway through. As we go just a little bit forward here, we're looking at the helm, and it is quite unique to have a wheel facing in this type of orientation. But with a quick pull here, the wheel itself literally comes over here, slides into position. So now we have a nice forward facing helm that is still nice and easy to get in and around. But when you're at the dock entertaining, it does slide out of the way, making a really nice passageway down into the salon. We also have stern rail seats. These are an aftermarket stern rail seat. Really nice, in a great position of the Lumar jib winches that are located here. The tow rail itself is a aluminum tow rail, so very low maintenance. The only teak on this vessel is the seats in the cockpit and the small little handholds as you walk up forward. We have a custom Dodger. The canvas is in really good condition. The isinglass is nice and clear. We have outboard Genoa sheets and Genoa tracks, so it allows you to have a much larger head sail on this vessel as well. Inboard shrouds, which is very nice, so the walking up to the forward deck allows you easy access without having to twist in between. This is a Z-spar mast with in-mast furling. All of the halyards and sheet are led into the cockpit as well. And as we walk up forward, you're going to notice we have a very nice large anchor locker. This is a powered Lumar windlass with foot switches, allowing you to operate the windlass in the up or down position. We have a single bow roller with a Lumar Delta plow anchor, and then jib furling. The furling itself is on a pro furler, and the sheets are led back to the cockpit, as I was mentioning. So when you're at the helm, they're both at hand's reach, making it really nice to single hand or short hand this particular vessel. Once again, the inboard shrouds make it easy for you to walk forward. We have a very nice large Lumar Traveler up on the cabin top, allowing you to give additional points of trimming your mainsail. So beyond the vang and the main sheet, the Traveler also comes really nice into play here. Cockpit is quite large for a 34-foot vessel. We also have state-of-the-art electronics. This is a Raymarine C70 chart plotter GPS. Just above this is our Tri-Data. The Tri-Data is a Raymarine ST60. This gives our depth and speed, our wind point wind speed, and then this is the ST4000 plus autopilot head unit. So when the vessel is in position, it's literally a flip of a switch here, and then you can engage your autopilot. So a very nice feature here. This particular autopilot also has a self-tack, where you hit the minus 10 and minus 1 position, and it would tack off to the port or starboard side. The vessel is also equipped with a cockpit table. The cockpit table itself is a starwood table that locks up into position and then easily folds up out of the way when not in use. There's also two cockpit speakers found in here as well. Inside this particular lazarette locker is a very large storage area. So as you can see here, you can fit a lot of stuff, a very, very unique to have a locker of this size in a 34-foot vessel without giving up lots of interior room, which you're going to see in its design really accommodates that area quite well. So coming down below the vessel, we're going to have the galley off to the port side. The galley itself has a two-burner stove and oven with broiler. We have a stainless steel sink with a really nice cutting board or cover to give you additional counter space here when working. Really large lazarettes with you know, cabinetry found throughout. They also have the louvered door, so everything can ventilate quite well. On the opposite side here is our wine bottle storage. Every bit of this boat has just phenomenal use of space. It's very impressive. Top here is our utensil container, and then below this is additional storage. So you can see everything that they've done, they've just maximized the, you know, room and storage in this vessel. We have a nice tap-in microwave. This also has the glass turntable inside of it as well. And then directly across from the galley is the head and shower. It is a very large head and shower. You have great headroom in here. There are three opening hatches. This is the manual Japsco head, and then a nice sink. And then on the shower portion, the sink faucet pulls out, locks up into position here, and now you have a full shower. So just forward of this, we're coming into the salon. The salon itself has really nice blue fabric. It is in pristine condition down here, very, very well taken care of. As you can see, I'm 6'1", and the headroom that this boat possesses is quite unique. And this carries all the way up forward to the forward bulkhead as well. So great headroom. So if you're tall and you're looking for a boat that possesses good interior volume, I definitely think you should look at this 343. Just across to the starboard side is our electrical panel. We have our 12-volt electrical panel here, our ICOM 402 VHF, our Sony CD player. This is also AM, FM. And then just behind this is our 110 breaker system. We have AC input, water heater, battery charger, and all of your AC outlets. Notice this, the attention to detail on the fiddles. And the grab handles here. We have storage underneath each bench seat. And then up forward is a really nice stateroom. This is quite clever. This is a pocket door that they use. So instead of taking a full swing-in door, they are enabling this pocket door to come in here so it maximizes its volume. We have a really nice a V-berth here, a really nice upgraded mattress. This came from the factory. Additional shelving and a hanging locker found in this stateroom. So a phenomenal forward stateroom, two overhead lights, overhead hatch to let air in, and its own shake. So as we walk back aft, you can get a really nice picture and the height of you know, this salon and galley that it possesses. And the aft stateroom is quite unique. This is a true queen size bed found in the aft stateroom here. You're going to notice there are lots of opening hatches letting a lot of natural light in. We don't have any lights turned on in the vessel. This is just its natural light that it possesses. A very aft facing opening hatch too, which is quite unique. So when you're laying in bed, you always get really good cross ventilation. Also, you're going to notice there is a door here. This particular door accesses the lazarette locker that was off to the starboard side that we accessed from the cockpit. So you have double access to that very large lazarette locker. And then your own dedicated hanging and storage area, you know, found in that aft stateroom as well. The engine itself is located underneath the companionway steps. This is on a gas shock. So we have a beautiful engine here. This particular Yanmar only has 164 engine hours on it. So very, very low use, very well maintained, and in really good condition. Well, I hope you found this quick, brief video walkthrough helpful and informative. If you have any questions or would like more information on the Beneteau product or this particular 343, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile. My number is 619-507-4416, and you can contact me day or night. Thank you again, and I look forward to hearing from you.